Hey everyone, Yevi here with the Inkswell, and today we're going to be taking a look at a pen that I've wanted for quite a while, or at least this body style. I did have to go on a hunt for the right filling system for me, but hey, it is what it is. So, little disclaimer time before we take a look at the pen. I picked this up on the Pen Addict Slack and the Sell Trade channel for a ridiculously good price. Normally, you're going to find the pen on, like, Amazon for about $217 to $260, depending on the nib that you get, which still isn't a bad price. It puts it at about the same price as a custom 823. So there you go. It's really just coming down the fill system and whether or not you want an opaque or demonstrator body. Not bad choices, just personal preference. Now, you can find it on Amazon, eBay, Pen Addict Slack, or the virtual pen show on Instagram. So let's go ahead, though, and take a look at this pen. So normally, when you get a Pilot pen, it comes in a cardboard sleeve. Since this was secondhand, no cardboard sleeve. But the original owner at least kept the clamshell box, which is cool. Inside the clamshell, we have the custom 743. And yeah, he even kept the tag there, which... on the back of the tag, let's pull that out. We've got marked as a coarse nib, which is really cool. Go ahead and pull that off. Now, for those wondering, a coarse nib is essentially a double broad. The cool thing, this pen also has the nib indicator sticker. A lot of secondhand pens, you don't get this because people do like I do, and just rip it right off. So let's go ahead, and before we take a look at the pen, let's take a look at the contents of the box. So underneath the pen pillow, normally you only get one of these. I think Andrew tossed in a second one, but mine came with two black cartridges, the use and care guide, and the original warranty cards, which is pretty cool, even though this pen's definitely out of warranty by now. Put the pen pillow back in. That's one thing I've always liked about Pilot packaging. It's not really flashy. They focus mainly on the pen, and the packaging is really just to keep the pen safe till it gets to you. So let's go ahead and take a look at the pen really quick. Here on the clip, we've got Pilot. And by the way, on this clip, if it wasn't for that ball right there, that clip would not move. It is a very stiff clip. Keep that in mind if you want to buy this pen. I don't know on the 823, at least the clips that I tried on the 823 had the same stiffness going for them. So I don't know. You'd have to take a look at it and see which one suited your needs. Once again, personal preference, form, function, price, all that good stuff. Now, on the cap band, we've got Pilot, made in Japan, custom 743, and that is just stamped into the 14 karat gold trim, which you've got one ring holding the clip, then a dual ring on the bottom of the cap, followed by a single band at the base of the pen. So taking the cap off here, let's take a look at this nib. So the 743 comes with a number 15 Pilot nib. Wow, for a secondhand nib, this is the first time actually looking up close at it. That is a really good nib. It's almost flawless. But not that big of a section. Threads are pretty close, so depending on how you hold the pen, having the threads close like that could be a hindrance, but let's go ahead and take a look at how this pen writes. Okay, so for the writing sample, I went ahead and filled it with Robert Oster, which one is this? Fire and Ice. Good ink. Now, you're probably sitting there wondering, but Yevi, you had to black cartridges in the box. How did you fill it with Robert Oster? Glad you asked. The seller included a Con 70 converter. Yes, this pen takes a con 70. Well, anyways, enough talking. Let's get to the writing. As you can see, this is a very wet nib. This is cool. I started off with fountain pens with extra fines and fines, and I'm finding myself drawn more and more to these just beautifully fat, wet nibs. Now, let's go ahead and see how it does with everyone's favorite phrase here, and I'll see if I can pick up the speed for a change. Okay, if you noticed watching back through the video, I changed like grip positions and angle positions like 5-6 times while just writing this small section, and the pen kept up beautifully. I was expecting it to skip or maybe just thin out the line variation, but it didn't. I mean, seriously, look at the line here. That is a steady line. Which, even for a sloppy writer like me, that is impressive. I think I'm going to have to write a few letters with this thing. What do you think? So, if you like a broad nib, and you want a nib that's really going to show off the color of the ink, then get this pen. I mean, seriously, I'm going to hold the paper back up here for a second so you can see this. So this is Fire and Ice. And just look at how much ink is getting on this piece of paper. That is just insane. A good insane, but insane nonetheless. You know, let's go ahead and get to the final thoughts. I really want to talk a little bit more about this pen. A couple final thoughts on the 743, and I guess the best way to sum up this pen is to see what boxes it checks for me. So, as far as the price point goes, you're looking at $217 to $260. Now, that's on Amazon. You're not going to find this one in stores. The 823 you're going to find in stores, and it's going to be closer to that range by the time you use whatever coupon or whatever the case may be for the pen. Now, demonstrator. For the 743, no. This is an opaque body, and you can get it in either black or burgundy. If you want the demonstrator body, you do have to go with the 823. Now, fill system, if you want the cartridge converter, you have to go 743. If you want the vacuum system, you have to go 823. That part is not interchangeable. As far as the nib goes, this is what puts both of these pens on very equal footing. So on both of them, you're getting a number 15, 14-karat nib. Now, what about size? Are these two pens equal in size? When I was looking at the spec sheets, I don't have an 823 with me, so I can't do a true side-by-side. But when I was looking at the spec sheets, they are almost identical. I'm just going to say almost even here, because identical is going to take way too long to write. So what is the final verdict? I really need to quit rotating my pen like that when I do that line. About the pen, though, would I buy this pen again? Yes. No doubt. Even if I wasn't finding it on Slack and got the deal that I did, I would still be more than happy paying this range for this pen. Now, like I was saying, if you want to have the demonstrator and you want the vacuum fill and you want to buy a brand new pen that no one else has ever touched, then head on over to penchalet.com, click on the radio podcast link at the top of the page, and enter in Inktwell in the How You Heard About Us section. Then go take a look at the Pilot 823, put it in your cart, take a look at the price, and thank me later. If you want the 743, head on over to Amazon, type in custom 743, pick your nib size, and run with it. If you want to try your hand at maybe finding a better deal, then head on over to eBay, take a look there, take a look at the virtual pen show. Also, join the Pen Addict Slack and join Sell Trade. I'm not responsible for what happens to your wallet if you do that, but it's a good place to actually pick up quite a few used pens. Thank you guys for watching. You can find me on Twitter and Instagram at TheInktWell. You can find me at floor3media.com/TheInktWell. And I believe you can find me at TheInktWell.com, which reroutes to my YouTube now, as well as Yevgeny.com, which is a URL that I totally forgot I had over the last year. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time. Oh yeah, one last thing. I want to do something special for you subscribers. So if we can get to 100 subscribers, I'm going to work with Ron and Braden over at Pen Chalet to get some kind of giveaway going. So once we hit that number, keep an eye out and we'll get that going. Thank you for watching. See you next time.